Ray Fresh killing the beat. And it looks like things are getting worse for Casanova. So not only is he pleading for his life in letters to the judge, but now, and renouncing his gang affiliation to the Gorilla Stones, which could be what led up to this situation. But he just got his face slashed in jail. Looks like Casanova caught a smooth $150. For his renouncing his gang affiliation, especially while in jail. I mean, we've seen this happen with Quando Rondo. He wasn't in jail at the time, so I don't think there was much that he could have, you know, there was much that as far as consequences that he would have had to deal with. But Casanova being a very, and I mean, this is all alleged, but him being an alleged prominent member, according to what the judge is saying, if he is what he is, then that could be a problem for him writing letters and all the disparaging things he had to say about the quote unquote gang that he was, involved in. So I don't know, man. Hopefully, he can get it together, man. Hopefully, they do make some type of provisions to keep him safe, which may or may not be his choice, whether or not he chooses to go PC or whatever the case may be. Which, I mean, at this point, since you're denouncing the gang, you might as well. I mean, I don't see why not. You might as well just PC. I mean, if you're going to risk doing this. I did hear that he attacked his attacker and cut him as well. But from what they're saying, he got the worst of it. So there aren't. They haven't released any, like, of course, pictures or anything. That I think there's a video out right now, but you know, like I said, man, prayers out to Casanova, man, and hopefully he not only beats his case, but hopefully there's no severe damage caused by that $150. I'm gonna play this clip by this is MSNBC, I believe, just the news clipping. Just so to get a little bit more information about what happened exactly.
After a former New York City rapper who was awaiting sentencing on federal drug charges got slashed in a vicious altercation with another inmate. It happened yesterday afternoon, and investigative reporter Sarah Wallace has inside information. I should get
paid for the work I put in. I'm so Brooklyn. Former Brooklyn rapper Casanova, whose real name is Coswell Sr., isn't going back to his hometown streets anytime soon. The self-proclaimed blood gang member who pleaded guilty to federal drug conspiracy charges last year was involved in a vicious...
They said this nigga is self-proclaimed, so it just kind of makes it hard. I mean, I just laugh at that because it kind of makes it hard when you write a letter claiming that you're not a part of the gang and you're clearly not only in interviews but in your music. That's all you're claiming, so...
fight yesterday at the Essex County Correctional Facility in Newark. These internal reports from correction officers say Senior was slashed with a weapon by another inmate, Ulysses Lugo, and then chased him down with the help of others. We spoke with one officer who responded to the scene.
Inmate Lugo, you couldn't see his face because he was saturated in blood. You couldn't see it at the time because his whole face was saturated in blood.
Fuck this nigga up.
And his whole uniform.
And I know New York niggas like to get him $150. That's why I keep saying that, because I'm pretty sure they tried to $150 this nigga.
Yeah, was saturated in blood. Inmate Senior was sitting there and blood was just coming out of his face.
A spokesman for the county told us this minor incident and whether weapons were employed is under investigation. Insiders tell us the unit was not searched last night or this morning, but in a recent interview with me, the director insisted they have implemented enhanced searches.
We're doing the searches two shifts a day. I'm doing everything that you can from a correctional administrator handbook done.
And then there's the issue of officer training. Retired Correction Lieutenant Jim Teresi reiterated what we've highlighted in recent stories.
Took a four-month officer with no academy training, and we put her alone with 64 federal prisoners who she has no idea who they are or what they're there for.
They have her in there. I mean, you guys seen Casanova. I mean, he I don't know how tall he is, but I mean, he looks like he's a pretty big dude. So imagine one female CO around 65 inmates. They were going to take that opportunity. I don't know why they, I think that was kind of, I don't know, it makes you kind of wonder whether or not certain shit is set up for him to, you know what I mean, for these people to get attacked or whatever.
January state law will require correction officers to go through the police academy before they oversee inmates. But in the meantime, the numbers are disturbing. Since March, before yesterday, there were 17 codes, inmate on inmate assaults or inmate on officer assaults. Ironically, yesterday's violence came on the same day that a jury found three inmates guilty of the 2021 jail beating of Jayshon Boyd. Two were convicted of attempted murder.
I remember
Boyd
that.
Suffered permanent brain damage. His family has filed a civil lawsuit against the murder. Boyd suffered. Sean Boyd is guilty of the 2021 jail.
I remember this situation. I remember this video going viral. This dude went, he got permanent brain damage. Are you serious?
Beating of Jayshon Boyd. Two were convicted of attempted murder. Boyd suffered permanent brain
damage.
His family has filed a civil lawsuit against the county.
Are you surprised that there's still cases of violence after this happened to your son?
Yes. Yes, I am.
He looked like a kid, too. Something needs to be done.
This is a violent. Boyd suffered permanent brain damage.
Two were convicted. This dude looked like he was a kid. He was probably like 18. 17, 18. There's no way. That's a kid.
Of attempted murder. Boyd suffered permanent brain damage. His family has filed a civil lawsuit against the county.
Are you surprised that there's still cases of violence after this happened to your son?
Yes. Yes, I am. They're doing nothing about it. Something needs to be done.
No weapons were.
That's crazy. That's crazy. So, yeah, man. I don't know. That situation was fucked up. I didn't even know. I remember that. Like I said, I remember that video going viral, but I didn't know that dude ended up with brain damage and all that shit. I mean, I knew he lived from it, but yeah, as far as Casanova goes, man, hopefully he heals up, man, and hopefully this case gets a little bit better for him and he's able to make it out and rap about and getting the buck, catching the buck 50 in jail. It's not funny, but I mean, you know, like I said, these rappers rap about this shit. This is the kind of life they rap about and glorify. And now it's just coming down to crunch time when they got to really step up to the plate and show us whether or not they really about that shit. So, but still, like I said before, I don't wish jail or death on no black man. So shouts out to Casanova and hopefully he is able to make it out, man. I'm going to catch you on the next video, man. Y'all like, share, subscribe, leave a comment in the comment box. Appreciate y'all. Trey Fresh.